Welcome back to the continuation of the module on building leadership capabilities in engineers, the introductory module. So far we have covered 5 sessions in this regard, building capabilities among engineers with relation to leadership. We have introduced the concept, we have talked about the importance of leadership, we discussed the meaning, the process, the functions of leadership. We also talked about the types of leaders. Basically, the 3 categories which Levin has talked about. Today, we will be talking about 2 more recently discussed styles of leadership. We will be talking about the recent developments and the recent discussions related to leadership. We will start with transactional leadership. You may look at the slide, what it means. Transactional leadership is also known as managerial leadership. It is all about managing others using rewards and punishments. People with this style tend to prefer a great deal of structure with clearly defined roles and expectations. Here, what is important is this clear definition of roles and expectations. So, what are the characteristics associated with this style? Lots of instruction, clear expectations, clear goals, inflexibility, efficiency, and a focus on rules. Once again, with reference to our previous discussions of styles of leadership, even with this style of leadership, there are certain merits, there are certain demerits. Let's first talk about the merits of this type of leadership. Transactional leaders usually lay out their rules and expectations. We have told this when we discussed about the characteristics. This itself will become a merit for the group. Each member of the group is given clear directions about what they should be doing, how they should be doing it, and when they should be done. You see the structure over here. The focus of this style is on making sure that things are completed correctly, on time, and according to the rules. Each of these words is equally important. Such leadership sees to it that the group achieves short-term goals quickly. Rewards and penalties are clearly defined for the employees in the organization. Because it is centered on productivity, efficiency, and safety, this can be an effective style when used within a clear organizational structure. Everything has to be structured well, and then this leadership style works very effectively. We talked about merits, but then there are demerits as well for each style of functioning. It can be stifling in settings where employees feel micromanaged. They are very keenly managed. Rewards the worker on a practical level. Money and perks can be external rewards. Creativity is limited because the goals and objectives are already set. There is a structured framework in which these people have to function, the employees have to function. It does not reward personal initiative, and because the style is so focused on extrinsic motivation, with rewards and bonuses offered for meeting and also for exceeding goals, followers may not develop what is called intrinsic motivation. The motivation to function does not come from within. It is always externally oriented for their work. This brings us to the discussion on yet another style of leadership called transformational leadership. Transformational leadership is characterized by high levels of motivation, inspiration, and commitment. People with this leadership style take charge of the group by presenting a clear vision of the outcome, display a great deal of passion for the work, and help group members feel inspired and committed to the goals. These are those exemplary leaders. People who have this characteristic style are often described as energetic, passionate, enthusiastic, trustworthy, creative, intelligent. All these qualities are seen in a transformational leader. As we have discussed with the other styles of leadership, even here we have merits and demerits. We will start with merits as we did with other styles of leadership as well. Transformational leaders are not only highly creative, they also inspire creativity in others. They are creative and they make others creative. They help others being creative. They inspire others to be creative. They offer support and guidance in order to help each member of the team achieve their fullest potential. team members look to the leader as a role model. This is what differentiates this style of leadership from all the other styles that we have been discussing so far. Because of this, followers tend to internalize the ideals of the leader and strive to emulate these qualities. Well, the merits continue. The leader is excellent at communicating new ideas, is good at balancing short-term vision and long-term goals as well, experience building strong coalitions and establishing mutual trust. They give trust, they demonstrate trust, they show trust, and they get trust. They have integrity and high emotional intelligence. They can empathize with the others. However, like for any style, even this transformational style has certain demerits or limitations. It is ineffective in initial stage or in ad hoc situations. Not always transformational style can be helpful. It requires an existing structure in order to be functional. It's a bad fit in many bureaucratic structures. Once again, an activity recommended to you. You may go through the videos related to transactional and transformational styles of functioning in leadership. And then I also request you to ponder over a few points. There are very interesting studies with relation to what is called Milgram's experiment. I would request you to gather some information related to Milgram's experiment, which talks about obedience in certain conditions. I would also request you to go through the fallacies of leadership. You will get information on this in several sites. I would request you to search and be informed about these two aspects as well. It may also be interesting to you to read certain recent analysis of leadership patterns. I have given you the sites. You may go through them. Today, on day 6, we have talked about two important recently discussed leadership styles. One is transactional leadership and the other is transformational leadership. This brings our module to a conclusion. We have talked about importance of leadership in the context of an engineer's profession and application of leadership skills. We have talked about meaning of leadership, the process, the functions, the types of leadership extensively. This concludes this module on building leadership capabilities in engineers. Thank you for being with us for these 6 days.